Hi everyone, in this video we'll go through different types of one marker questions. We'll go through matrices and determinants today. So here's the first question. A matrix A is given. You have to find 5 times of A transpose. So here, since there is A transpose, right? First you take the A transpose, right? That is, you swap the rows and columns. You have a row here, you make it into a column. You have second row, make it a second column, right? Then multiply with 5. Right, multiply with 5 and then you'll get this matrix. Now the second question is, a matrix is given. It's told that it's a singular matrix. You need to find the value of x, this one. A singular matrix is a matrix where the determinant is 0. Right, that's what is the definition for singular matrix. Now the determinant is 0. So you calculate. How do you calculate the determinant for 2 by 2? Right, you have to cross multiply and subtract. Cross multiply and subtract. So now you are cross multiplying. So we'll tell 5x. Minus, cross multiply, 10 into 2, 20. Minus of minus, 20 plus 20. 5x plus 20 is equal to 0. Because for singular matrix, determinant is 0. Right? Therefore, you can calculate the value of x, which is minus 4. So here's the third type of problem. Here again, you have to find the value of x. So this is a determinant. So how do you do? Cross multiply and subtract. So it will be x square minus 16 into 4. Right? Is equal to 0. That is nothing but x square minus 64 is equal to 0, or x square is equal to 64. And then you have to put, then x is square root of 64. So whenever there is square root, you have to put plus or minus and the number. Now another one is, find x such that this particular matrix is symmetric. Now what is the definition for symmetric? Symmetric means matrix A is same as transpose of matrix. That is, if you take this particular matrix and take a transpose of it, it's going to be same. Right, there's not going to be any changes, it's going to be same. So now you take matrix A, take the transpose of it. That is, we swap the rows and columns, right? 3x is the row here. Here we have 3 and x, put it as a column. Here we have 4 and 7, put it as a column. And then now equate element by element, right? So wherever x is there, equate it. Now x and 4, x should be equal to 4. Similarly, here x is there, x should be equal to 4. Therefore, x is equal to 4. That is, the corresponding element should always be equal, right? This is by definition of equality of matrices. Since these two matrices are equal, the corresponding elements, that is the first element should be equal to first element here. Second element here should be equal to second element here. That way, wherever x is there, you equate it to the number in the other matrix. Therefore, x is equal to 4. Fifth type of problem is, again, you'll have to find the value of x here, right? So you cross multiply, it will be x into x square. A is equal to 12 into 3, which is 36. So x square minus 36 is equal to 0, or x square is equal to 36. Remember, this is a determinant, right? This is a determinant. So how do you calculate the determinant? Cross multiply and then subtract. So therefore, x becomes plus or minus 6. Remember, it's a square root. So it'll be plus or minus 6. This is another type of problem where we have to find the adjoint of the matrix. What is adjoint? Adjoint of a 2 by 2 matrix is nothing but you will have to swap the diagonal element, right? You have to swap this. So 7 minus 2 will become minus 2, 7. And then this side, you'll have to change the signs. So minus 5 will become plus 5 and plus 3 will become minus 3. That's the adjoint. Next problem is, again, a matrix is given. Find 2 times of it. Find 3 times of it. Find 2 times of the transpose. So here, first take the transpose. First find the transpose. And then multiplied with 2. Then here there's another problem. You have to show that A transpose of transpose is A. That is double transpose. So you take transpose once, then double transpose, right? You'll get the original matrix back, right? If you notice, after taking double transpose, this is same as the original matrix. Then here you have to find A plus B. So add the matrices. 1 plus 2, 2 plus 5, 3 minus 3, minus 1, minus 1. And here, these are determinant related problems. Here, whenever you have problems like this, try to take common factor out. Try to subtract the rows. Make the number very small. So you can subtract this row with this, right? So you can subtract row 2 with row 1 like this, right? So 3202 minus 3200 is 2. 3203 minus 3201 is 2. So like this you subtract, then take 2 as common and you'll get like a simplified determinant like this. Now you cross multiply. Now you cross multiply and subtract. Right? Similarly here, this is another example. Same thing you can practice. Right? Here again you subtract the rows. Subtract the rows. Right? The numbers will become small. Take the common factor and you will get the answer. Now you have to prove that this particular determinant is 0 without expansion. That is, you'll have to make the number small. Right? So now if you notice in this row, first figure out if you can take any common factor. That should be the first step. If you can simplify the numbers, if you can take anything as common factor. If you notice, you can take 5 as common here in this row. So if I take 5 as common, I'll get 1, 5, 7. So I have identical rows. So one of the determinant properties is, if you have two identical rows, then the determinant is 0. That's how we have proven that determinant is equal to 0. Now here, if all the elements in a row or a column of a determinant are zeros, then the value of the determinant is 0. So if you have, that is like this, right? If you have a row, say, like this. If you have a row with all zeros, then the determinant is zeros. Similarly, if you have a column with all zeros, then the determinant is zeros. Now find the value of this particular determinant. Again, this is a determinant property indirectly, right? Whenever you have zeros like this, if you notice, there is zeros in the corners, right? Only the diagonal elements have some values. Everything else is zeros. So in this case, determinant is simply, you have to multiply these elements. You have to multiply these elements. So 7 into 5, 35. 35 into 3 is 105. So, and minus 105. So this is how you find the determinant when all the elements other than the diagonal elements are zeros. So with this, we've come to the end of this particular one marker video for matrices and determinants. If you like this video, do press a like and share it. See you in the next video. Thank you.